Hi guys, my name is Aneta and welcome to my art channel. In today's video, I'd like to share my thoughts on some Tintoretto brushes that I've been using for a while now. These are watercolor brushes made mainly from synthetic fibers. I would also like to review these two watercolor pans from the Rembrandt collection, which were a small disappointment, and I'll explain why. Every now and then I like to buy some single watercolor pans, not only because I'm curious of trying new things, but also because my goal is to create a watercolor palette that will not require too much tedious mixing, something that I already did with my gouache palette. I mean, on one hand, you should be able to know and understand the dynamics between different colors, different pigments, so I wouldn't fully advise this type of approach to a beginner student. Personally, I just reached a point where I want to simplify certain aspects of my process. The most annoying thing for me is when I prepare a batch of watercolor mixes and I use it all, but I still need some colors to finish my piece. I find it so hard to replicate the same color with the same amount of pigment. Saying that, these two Rembrandt pans were supposed to be, well, a little bit different. I saw these swatches on the internet and I thought I would get exactly what I saw. In few words, I expected a solid mix of kind of semi-transparent pigments with some mica in it, something like the famous Schmincke granulating colors, but with sparkles. As you can see, it wasn't like that at all. The difference between these two pans is that the color 861 contains a mix of red, violet, and blue pigments, whereas 862 is more on a violet, blue, and gold side. But to be perfectly fair, I don't see that much of a difference. This discovery kinda changed my plans, so in order to appreciate them fully and create what I had on mind, I had to make some mixes with normal colors and then apply those pigments. So as you can see, I took some samples of watercolor papers that were kindly gifted by a friend of mine and basically just played around with what I had. Thank you. These brushes, as I mentioned, are the Tintoretto brushes. Before I got them, I thought they were going to be a sort of major game changer in my whole process. And I mean, don't get me wrong, they're very good. I'm happy I have them, but for the future, I think I'll choose something else. I like the fact that you can really control your lines and they hold water and the pigment very well. When it comes to the Tintoretto Aquascent brush, which is that big boy with the green handle, I think that overall it does the job beautifully. It handles a lot of pigment and water. I'm not gonna lie, I took this brush because I firmly believe having a big sized watercolor brush in your collection is very beneficial, and it will definitely make your life easier with that first wash of watercolor. But there is a but. But it doesn't need to be this one, or at least don't take brushes with white bristles. Seriously, I like to keep my brushes clean, obviously. And what happened to this Aquascent brush is that while painting during one of my sessions, some blue pigment managed to enter the part covered by this transparent plastic, and when I wash it, that pigment becomes liquid again and it goes up to the tip of the brush. So as it dries, you can see some stains again. And I get it, this is a first world problem, but I think it could be better than that. Hopefully with time I'll remove that pigment from the inside. Overall, these types of brushes I'm showing you are mostly quill or mop brushes. That means they are following a traditional technique. Hence, you can find a wire wrapped around the lower part. And for someone who likes to keep fingers on that part of the handle, especially while working on some minor details, I must say this is not the most comfortable option. It looks pretty, I know, but it hurts on a long run. So for the future, I think I'll go with normal metal ferrules. And we are approaching the final results of this small swatching experiment. And overall, I am pleased with the effect. These pans contain a very generous amount of pigment, so I think I might keep one of them in my main palette. I would like to see how they are going to behave with acrylic inks as well. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was insightful, or at least it convinced you whether some things are worth buying or not. And on my next video, we'll actually paint something. So stay tuned, subscribe if you haven't yet, and I'll see you in my next video. Ciao!